Hi, and welcome back. I'm Dr. Robert Lupo, MD. I'm a board-certified orthopedic surgeon, and today we're going to discuss actual rotator cuff surgery. This is a surgery that I did on a patient. I'll give you an idea of what to expect and how the surgery is done. First, a disclaimer. This is for educational, informational purposes only and may not be construed as medical advice. So please, discuss your medical condition with your doctor before making any decisions in regards to your health care. Okay, so this surgery is done as a same-day surgery, and this is an operating room. Anesthesia is at the top of the table. This is the position the patient is in. This is called a beach chair position, and basically it's just kind of a sitting upright position, and this is a special head holder that holds the head in place. The arm is sterilely prepped. And then after it's sterilely prepped, it's placed in this big blue drape, this big blue sterile drape. So the arm is prepped and sterile. And this is a mechanical arm holder, lets us hold everything in place. Here's the video monitor down there. So we're inside the shoulder, we're probing around. And you can see here's the biceps tendon. This is the socket, very flat kind of dish. Here's the ball part of the shoulder on the left side of the screen. We do a systematic approach to evaluate the entire shoulder from top to bottom. There's the rotator cuff again, and here's our rotator cuff tear along the side. You can see this big hole in here. Okay, so we're going to go back. Now we're on top of the rotator cuff, not inside the joint anymore. And what I'm doing with this is a shaver. This is shaving down the undersurface of the bone called the acromion. Remember where that bone spur was? Well, we're going to remove all the soft tissue under here so I can see everything. And then we're going to take a burr and see this? This is all bone spur. Then we're going to remove all that. Let me come back here. All right, we'll show you again real quick. So here's the big tear. Again, I'm removing all the soft tissue. Okay, and you have to remove the soft tissue to use the burr, because otherwise the burr will get clogged. And this is an electrocautery, stop any bleeding, and also it's very nice to remove tissue. Okay, so here's the burr, here's the flat part of the bone. This is all bone spur from here to here. So that little spike of bone is rubbing on the tendon and likely caused it to tear. So I'm just going to come along the backside and slowly remove it until it's nice and flat. And you can see now it's nice and flat. Here's the deltoid attachment in the front of the shoulder, so we didn't detach the muscle. Here's the bone spur, nice and flat now. So now we're going to go over to the bone where it's supposed to attach. Now this is the rotator cuff tendon. This is all torn. Here's the, this is just a shaver. I'm just shaving things away so we get nice visualization. But again, here, this is the tendon that's torn. Here's the rotator cuff tendon here. And this is the torn edge. And this edge is supposed to be attached down to the bone over here. You see, this is a very sizable tear. It goes across the whole length of the tendon. You see the muscle over there. So I'm going to take this grasper, and I'm going to show you that's where the tendon belongs. So I'm debriding the bone, creating a nice, healthy bed of bone to reattach the tendon to. Now I'm going to put anchors into the bone. I'm basically punching a hole into the bone. Here's a tendon edge here. Okay, and I'm going to put an anchor into the bone here. There's another picture showing that. So here comes the anchor. It has this special tape attached to it. So you can see me pushing the anchor in, and then I'll start screwing the anchor into the bone. And you see the threads coming in here. And I'll repeat that step at another level. Then I'm going to pass those sutures through the tendon. Here they are coming through the tendon here. See, there's the suture. There's the biceps tendon. I'm passing this, what's called fiber tape through the tendon. Just got to pull it through. So now there's an anchor in the bone here, and the suture's coming out over here. And I'm going to repeat that process in the back. I pass the suture. My assistant isn't quite holding the camera as steady as I'd like, but when you're doing the surgery, it's going by fast. So here's the two anchors in the bone, and here they are coming out over here. Then we're going to take those tendons, or those fiber tape, and we're going to bring it over to a hole on the side of the bone. So here you can take one suture strand from each one. We bring it over, and now you can see the tendon nicely reduced back to where it belongs. I'm just finding the best spot to put that. And then what you do is you basically take the tendon, take the suture, and you attach it to the lateral anchor. So here I am putting a screw into the lateral side of the joint, into the ball part of the shoulder on the outside that's fixing that tendon down. So there's the first one. You can see here's the tendon nicely reapproximated back to bone. Now I'm going to take another set. I'm going to bring them crisscross, and basically that fixes my tendon tear. So I'm going to do another anchor over here. There I am screwing in my anchor. And then we'll take a look here at our repair. So that's our repair. Nice and secure. No motion at that interface. Those are the two anchors on the lateral side. And I'll move the shoulder around here in a minute, and you can see that now there's no more opening at the end of that tendon. And that's what the final repair looks like. So this is before and after picture. So here's the big hole. Here it is after we're fixed. Bone spurs require removal at the same time. So here's the bone spur. Here it is after the bone spur is removed. What about the AC joint? The AC joint can get arthritic, and it can have big bone spurs. So again, this is what we do. We go in, we remove the bone spur. This is a very common overuse injury, common in weightlifters and swimmers. They have pain on the top of the shoulder, hurts with shoulder motion. Frequently is treated with just rest and ice and anti-inflammatories and sometimes steroid injections, but if all else fails, surgery is the only way to cut out the arthritic joint, and it's highly successful. For my contact information or for more videos, please go to my website, drrobertlupo.com. Thank you.